Okay guys, this is a quick tutorial on how to export or import into or out of iMovie a lot quicker than you normally would. I've only got about 4 gigabytes of RAM, so for me this is pretty darn fast. I'm hoping to upgrade that soon, but things don't happen the way we would like them to. Sorry about that, my dog jumped. Okay, so this right here, this is the key, right there. Okay, this is an external hard drive that I've got. It is 500 gigabytes, but it's only got 56 available, but that doesn't matter. This is a hard drive. All you have to do is have this connected, and when you go to import or export out of or into iMovie, you tell it to use this for something. If you are exporting to your drive, then you want to import to your hard drive in your computer. I'm trying to make this actually make sense. Okay, so if you are going to be exporting everything that you make into here, like say I've got a folder for iMovie right here, then I will, you know, I export here, okay? I'm exporting to this drive, right? So then I need to import to my regular disk drive, okay? That means you don't really, it's really simple. You just don't put it in here, okay? I'll show you what I mean in just a minute after this is finished. So I will be right back. Okay, the video has uploaded, and as you can see, it is 2 hours long, and I imported it, not uploaded, sorry, I imported it in about 7 minutes, and it was a 2 hour long video in HD, not 1080, but it is 720. I did that for export timing reasons. Anyway, okay, so I'm actually gonna simulate this again. The way I imported this movie is I went up to, of course, File, Import Movies. Now, it'll go ahead, by default, try to add to an existing event. I would probably choose Create New Event if you're, you know, making a new category for something, but anyway. Save to, and if you have an external hard drive, this will show up. Not this in particular, of course, but, you know, whatever you have your hard drive named as, it will show up here. As you can see, 56 gigabytes free. And, as you can see, it's already there. See, sorry. Okay, it's right here. That's where I imported it. And really, it's this simple. It will be on this as on default, by default, sorry. And you will just change it to your hard drive. And I am not joking, this is all you have to do. And you hit import and it will take half the speed. The reason for this is a computer can only, by default, you know, unless it's some sort of weird supercomputer with several hard drives at once, it can only read or write. It cannot do both. Okay, and what that means is it reads what it's trying to import, and then it writes it, okay? So, pretty much, it's looking at the video, if that's what you're reading and writing. It takes that video, looks at it, and then writes it into here, okay? That's pretty much what read and write means in this instance, okay? So, if you are reading and then writing and then reading and then writing, of course it's going to take longer because it has to switch back and forth. But if you have two hard drives, then it can read and write at the same time. It will read it with the hard drive that you've got in your computer and write it to the external hard drive. So it can be doing both at once and cut your time in half. Thank you for watching. I hope this was informative. If you liked the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Thanks, guys. See ya.